Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We are daughters and sons of him who build the valleys and our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his name.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we begin this Holy Mass, let us prepare ourselves by acknowledging our many sins and by asking God's forgiveness. Let us also entrust ourselves to God's merciful love. Lord Jesus, you give us new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Kings. When Athaliah, the mother of Ahaziah, saw that her son was dead, she began to kill off the whole royal family. But Jehosheba, daughter of King Jehoram and sister of Ahaziah, took Joash, his son, and spirited him away along with his nurse from the bedroom where the princes were about to be slain. She concealed him from Athaliah, and so he did not die. For 6 years, he remained hidden in the temple of the Lord while Athaliah ruled the land. But in the 7th year, Jehoiada summoned the captains of the Koreans and of the guards. He had them come to him in the temple of the Lord, exacted from them a sworn commitment, and then showed them the king's son. The captains did just as Jehoiada the priest commanded, each one with his men, both those going on duty for the Sabbath and those going off duty that week, came to Jehoiada the priest. He gave the captains King David's spears and shields, which were in the temple of the Lord. And the guards with drawn weapons lined up from the southern to the northern limit of the enclosure, surrounding the altar and the temple on the king's behalf. Then Jehoiada led out the king's son and put the crown and the insignia upon him. They proclaimed him king and anointed him, clapping their hands and shouting, "Long live the king!" Athaliah heard the noise made by the people and appeared before them in the temple of the Lord. When she saw the king standing by the pillar, as was the custom, and the captains and trumpeters near him, with all the people of the land rejoicing and blowing trumpets, she tore her garments and cried out, "Treason! Treason!" Then Jehoiada the priest instructed the captains in command of the force, "Bring her outside through the ranks. If anyone follows her," he added, "let him die by the sword." He had given them orders that she could not be slain in the temple of the Lord. She was led out forcibly to the horse gate of the royal palace, where she was put to death. Then Jehoiada made a covenant between the Lord as one party and the king and the people as the other, by which they would be the Lord's people, and another covenant between the king and the people. Thereupon, all the people of the land went to the temple of Baal. They demolished it. They shattered its altars and images completely and slew Matan, the priest of Baal, before the altars. Jehoiada appointed the detachment for the temple of the Lord. All the people of the land rejoiced and the city was quiet, now that Athaliah had been slain with the sword at the royal palace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling.
The Lord swore to David a firm promise from which he will not withdraw. Your own offspring I will set upon your throne.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling.
If your sons keep my command, or my covenant and the decrees which I shall teach them, their sons too forever shall sit upon your throne.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling.
For the Lord has chosen Zion. He prefers her for his dwelling. Zion is my resting place forever. In her will I dwell, for I prefer her.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling.
In her will I make a horn to sprout forth for David. I will place a lamp for my anointed. His enemies I will clothe with shame, but upon him my crown shall shine.
The Lord has chosen Zion for his dwelling. Please stand.
Hallelujah.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and decay destroy, and thieves break in and steal. But store up treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor decay destroys, nor thieves break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there also will your heart be. The lamp of the body is the eye. If your eye is sound, your whole body will be filled with light. But if your eye is bad, your whole body will be in darkness. And if the light in you is darkness, how great will the darkness be?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, in our gospel today, Jesus talks about treasures. And Jesus distinguishes between two kinds of treasures: the treasures on earth and the treasures in heaven. Jesus says that treasures on earth do not last. They deteriorate. They rot in time. Ang kayamanan sa mundong ito, hindi naman nagtatagal, mabilis mawala, kung hindi man nabubulok agad. Yung pera, mabilis mawala. Sa mahal ng presyo ng mga bilihin ngayon, yung sinweldo nyo nung isang araw, sandali lang, nawala na agad. Yung mga bagay sa mundong ito, hindi naman nagtatagal. Nasisira, nabubulok, inaanay, nawawala. At maging ang ating sariling katawan, darating ang araw, mabubulok din, mawawala din. Treasures on earth do not last. They rot in time. But you know, my dear brothers and sisters, what is worse is that treasures on earth do not only rot in time, they also corrupt our hearts. Ang kayamanan sa mundong ito, hindi lamang nabubulok, binubulok din ito ang ating puso. Kaya kapag ang ating tuon lamang ay sa kayamanan ng mundong ito, unti-unti nitong kakainin, bubulokin ang ating puso at ang ating pagkatao. We see a perfect example of this in our first reading today. When King Ahaziah died, his mother, Queen Athaliah, wanted to grab the throne for herself. Ang sumusunod sa hari, kapag namatay ang hari, ay yung anak nung hari. Pero ang nanay nung hari ang nagnais na maging hari, ang mamuno sa kanyang bayan. And in order for Athaliah to be assured of the throne, she had ordered that all those possible successors to the throne be killed, even her own relatives, para wala nang ibang qualified na mamuno. Ipinapatay niya ang lahat ng posibleng mamuno, lahat ng nasa linya noong haring namatay, para siya lang ang mamuno. Pero ibig sabihin nun, yung kanyang mga pinapatay ay kanyang sariling kamag-anak, kanyang sariling dugo. But little did she know that the sister of the king was able to hide Joash, the son of the king, and the rightful successor to the throne. For 6 years, Joash remained hidden, and Athaliah reigned as queen of the land. But after 6 years, the priest Jehoiada brought out Joash and presented him to the people as the rightful king. And so Joash was made king, and Athaliah was killed. See, my dear brothers and sisters, how powers on earth easily fade away. Yung kapangyarihan na akala niya magpakailanman na nasa kanya, sandali lang naglaho agad. And see also how earthly power corrupted her heart, the heart of Athaliah, so much so that she had people killed just so she could be assured of earthly power. My dear brothers and sisters, because treasures on earth rots in time and corrupts our hearts, Jesus tells us in our gospel today, do not treasure, do not store them up for yourselves. Huwag niyong pag-ipunan yung kayamanan sa mundong ito na nabubulok at binubulok ang ating puso. Rather, Jesus says, store up treasures in heaven, because treasures in heaven do not fade away. They last forever. Treasures in heaven make our hearts pure. Treasures in heaven make us worthy of heaven. And so today, my dear brothers and sisters, we ask ourselves, what do you keep? What do you treasure? What do you store up? What do you work hard for? Ano ba ang pinagsisikapan mo? At ano ba ang pinagtatrabahuhan mo? What do you strive to attain? Treasures on earth or treasures in heaven?
Please stand.
Jesus challenges us to store up treasures in heaven rather than earthly treasures. Let us set our hearts on heaven as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may free men and women from the slavery of materialism by constantly teaching the values of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That politicians and civil leaders may initiate programs and projects for the integral development of society and its constituents. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people who are entrusted with great wealth may realize their status as stewards rather than absolute owners of the goods they possess. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are deprived of the things of this world may realize the beauty of setting one's hearts on heavenly treasures. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffered and died in faith may gain their heavenly reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our personal petitions. We pray for the people we promise to pray for. And we also pray for all the intentions offered in this Mass. Heavenly Father, your love for us never changes or fades away. Give us the courage to walk in your presence all the days of our life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We thank all of you for joining our Mass this morning here at the Manila Cathedral. Thank you for those who are joining the live streaming of this Mass. And in a special way, we thank the pilgrims from St. Monica Parish Church in Agoola, Union, led by Reverend Father Ronaldo Chan. Maraming salamat po sa pagpunta ninyo dito ngayong umaga sa Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpalang nilikha, ipinagpalang